Sea ice is a dynamic force that drives ecosystems, shapes climate, and traps ships. As shown by this thin layer of sea ice pushed onshore by wind, sea ice is constantly in motion. The ice moves even when it seems solidly frozen, often many miles a day. Sea ice forms in both of the Earth's polar regions. Currently, some sea ice in the Arctic never melts, while most sea ice surrounding Antarctica melts away every year. That's because Arctic seas are mostly surrounded by landmasses that constrain ice, while at the other end of the planet, the continent of Antarctica is surrounded by ocean. Radar is an essential instrument for understanding sea ice. Radar can see through the pole's constant winter darkness and frequent cloud cover. This example shows sea ice near Barrow, Alaska. In radar images, sea ice is usually white and gray. Water is often black. The formation of sea ice helps drive ocean currents around the world. When seawater first freezes, the ice crystals form a film called frazzle. As the crystals form, they eject salt into the surrounding water. The saltier the water, the heavier it is, so it sinks. The ocean becomes layered with ice on top of cold water, on top of heavier, saltier water. Those layers move in currents around the world, playing a large role in global climate. Cold water is shown here in blue. In this radar image, swirls of new ice reveal tidal eddies around Bering Sea islands. Winds and currents drive even the densest, thickest ice, as shown in the patterns of this fracturing Arctic ice, along with some cloud cover, captured by a radiometer. Arctic sea ice travels in two main routes. It circles the Arctic Ocean, or it moves from the Arctic Ocean to the Atlantic. Winds and currents affect ice as soon as ice crystals form. In rough water, frazzle tends to transform into pancake ice. In calm water, frazzle tends to coalesce into a soupy mix called grease ice, which then thickens into a sheet. As sea ice builds, it can raft, with winds pushing pieces on top of each other, and large pressure ridges can form. Radar tracks all of these changes. This image shows sea ice along the coast of Canada. When sea ice melts in the spring, it releases tiny organisms that nourish blooms of phytoplankton. These blooms drive entire ecosystems, including the Bering Sea fishery, which supplies more than half of the U.S. seafood catch. The ice also serves as a critical platform and even transportation for wildlife. For example, most Pacific walruses migrate by riding the pack ice. In recent decades, Arctic sea ice has diminished dramatically with climate change. With the loss of ice, the region has lost white surface that reflects sunlight. The darker water absorbs heat from the sun, which then further warms surrounding ice, as well as the atmosphere, causing even more melting. This cycle affects even small opening among ice floes, in the melt ponds that form on top of the ice. In the open water, larger waves develop, playing a role in the erosion of Arctic coastlines. Radar imagery detects ice movement from its formation to its melting. These examples show sea ice in the Bering Strait, with Russia on the left and Alaska on the right. They are part of a dataset available from the Alaska Satellite Facility that shows sea ice motion during a dramatic decline in Arctic sea ice from 1995 to 2012.